easy go.
Best lap so far is a 1:42.6.
Hey, looks like you've got a bit of rivalry going on out there. This is good. Gets people talking about you. Just make sure you outperform them, okay?
Just letting you know that we've had the team's expectations through for the upcoming qualifying session.
Welcome F1 fans, where qualifying will be starting in the next few minutes as the teams prepare to get out on track at the Sochi Autodrome here in Russia.
Grid is all set then for the race tomorrow, but before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Hamilton, Rosberg, and Daniel Ricciardo.
How are you? I have some information on the race goals you should keep in mind.
Welcome one and all to the Russian Grand Prix. We're just a stone's throw from the Georgian border here at Sochi as we get ready to begin the race that served up an absolute cracker back in 2015. A last lap collision between Kimi Raikkonen and Valtteri Bottas sparked controversy in that race, so let's hope the racing is just as tight today. Built on the shores of the Black Sea, the Sochi Autodrome is a 3.6-mile tour around some of the venues built for the 2014 Winter Olympic Games. Close barriers may make overtakes more challenging, but with 56% of the lap taken absolutely flat out, we certainly won't be wanting for pure speed.
this lap. 4 seconds.
Thank you.
distance to the leader is 19.2 seconds. Okay, some information on Perez. They're speeding up again, so I expect they've fixed whatever the problem was.
Stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. Tell me, Ant, what was the key to this success?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Well, the lead at the top has come down after a poor result for our points leader. Moving on to the driver of the day then. Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
Fernando Alonso. Wherever he is, whatever team he's in, when is he not just brilliant?
So the board and I have been talking about your contract. And we all agree, the only thing better than a number two driver is a number one driver. Here are the details.